rolling.
Speed.
Once again, black smoke. For 2 days, the conclave of cardinals, locked behind the doors of the Sistine Chapel, have attempted to elect a pope. And their only link with the outside world, that thin column of smoke that rises from the stove in which each ballot is burned. 10 times, black smoke has risen, no verdict. And each time, the crowd standing vigil prays that next time, white smoke will billow forth. And the traditional cry, Habemus Papam, we have a pope, will be heard here and throughout the entire Catholic world. This is Cleet Roberts, Vatican City, Rome.
No more for me. I want to be able to see the white smoke when it shows.
How much longer do you think, Cleet?
Well, Joe, when they elected Pope Benedict XIV, it took 255 ballots.
Deadlock?
Looks like neither the conservatives or the liberals have enough votes.
Sooner or later, they'll have to go with a compromise.
An interim pope, most likely, an old man who can be counted on to do nothing. And then, some years later, when he passes on, they'll hold another election and put in a strong pope.
Who's the best bet for the interim pope?
Roncalli.
Angelo Cardinal Roncalli, the Patriarch of Venice. He's popular, easygoing, and he's 77.
77 years old? If they elect a man that old, they will have a do-nothing interim pope.
Well, maybe. Maybe not.
You sound as if you know Roncalli.
Well, I do know one story about him.
Well, Joe, tell us.
Well, during World War II, he was apostolic delegate to Turkey, kind of an ambassador from the Pope. I think there were less than 20,000 Catholics in the country at the time. Not a very challenging job for a man who'd given almost 40 years to the church.
Take whatever food we can spare to Mrs. Kramer. Tommaso has the address.
Angelo, you're late for your appointment.
My dear sister, Mrs. Kramer's husband is missing in action. Her two small children will not starve. Tommaso...
My dear brother, your appointment is waiting for you in the study. Rabbi Herzog and his friends.
Herzog.
And if you don't go to them soon, they will starve.
And I doubt that all our extra food...
Which you gave away 2 days ago...
would help.
Why?
Grace.
Oh, the dietary laws. Difficult problem. Isaac.
Angelo.
You remember Monsignor Ryan?
Rabbi. Of course. Archbishop Roncalli, Monsignor Ryan, may I present Rachel Friedman?
Hello.
And Melach Ben Zvi. How do you do?
May I make amends for being late by offering you some refreshments.
No, that will not be necessary. We are very grateful that you can spare us your time knowing your schedule.
Please be seated. Be seated. Isaac. How can I help you?
Angelo. I rushed here from Jerusalem on a desperate mission. Melech here is captain of the vessel Laro. This small boat carries a most precious cargo. 647 Jewish children. Rachel.
The children, they were either orphans or were forcibly and tragically separated from their parents. They range in age from 6 to 14. For the last 6 months, we've smuggled them out of camps in Hungary, Czechoslovakia, Poland, and Germany. When we finally got them on Laro and out to sea, well, we thought our problems were over.
Where were you taking them?
Israel.
Eretz Israel. But the British, the humane protectors for Palestine, discovered us making for Haifa and refused us entry.
But why? How could they do that?
Their entry quota laws. They're enforcing them.
Where else in the Mediterranean could we go but here?
These two. It is their courage that has kept the children alive and free these last months.
At times, I think it was only the children's faith that kept us going.
You brought each other to safety.
Apparently not.
Your Excellency, pending the outcome of discussions with the country from which the ship last sailed...
Nazi Germany?
The Turkish government refuses to grant the children asylum.
Turkish government? What reason do they give?
Children have no papers.
Hundreds of people come into this country without papers and have stayed.
There is one difference. These are Jews without papers.
Angelo, the Germans have made an issue with the government. They are demanding that the ship and everyone on it be surrendered so it can be returned to the port from which it sailed illegally.
Surely the Turkish government would not agree to these Nazi demands.
The foreign ministry has set Friday morning, 2 days from today, for the ship and the children to be surrendered.
Then we must ask the Turkish government to allow the children to stay.
No one in the government will see me. Representations have been made by the International Red Cross, and to no avail.
Tommaso, please call Foreign Minister Menomenziolo's office. I would like an immediate audience.
Immediate, Your Grace.
So I was born of poor Italian farmers. You came from the land of the Blarney Stone. You, I know, will find the proper words that will make the minister happy to see me immediately. Now, we must organize our few parishes. I'm sure you need additional clothing and food. My sister Maria will give you all we have.
Our biggest need is blankets.
Our biggest need is asylum.
The foreign minister is a man of humanity and honor. I am certain he will help. Arranged clearances for all my Romanians. Thank you. This is more than I dared hope for.
It was not an easy matter.
Day after day, I bring you impossible problems, and you solve them so quietly. I do not know what I have done to deserve such friendship.
Well, you are the only foreigner I have ever known who could pronounce my name without the flicker of an eye.
Your name? I could turn your name into a litany.
That will not be necessary.
You've done so much for us. Now I must ask for one more favor.
There is nothing I can do.
Then you know why I am here.
What you want, my friend, is impossible.
Just persuade the president to see me.
He will not see you. He says you are meddling in our political affairs once again.
That is the last thing I would want.
President Inono instructs me to read you this statement. In the matter of the ship La Roe and its cargo...
Its cargo? Its cargo is children.
The ship sails under no recognized flag, has no legal registry. The passengers are without passports or any other acceptable papers. The German government claims the ship was pirated, submits documents that catalog the crimes committed by the fugitives, and demands their return. Under the circumstances, the Turkish government has no alternative but to meet that demand.
The alternative would be to repudiate that demand and give these children the shelter of your neutrality.
And risk the loss of that neutrality? No. The German authorities assume full responsibility for the ship Friday morning.
Newman, come to the ship with me. Let us talk with Rabbi Herzog.
It couldn't change anything. I'm sorry. Angelo. Be careful.
Pray for me. In Islamic, of course.
Jews? A Gestapo matter.
France, I cannot believe this of you. Our friendship goes back many years.
This feeling of Hitler's about the Jews, it consumes him. The invasion of England fails, he murders Jews. The Russians resist more stubbornly than he expected, he murders Jews. And no sane or reasonable protest by me or anyone else will change him.
I am only asking you to help me save a shipload of children here, now, in Istanbul.
It's out of my hands.
You are the ranking German official in Turkey.
Now, wait a minute. If you want to help the children, go and see Colonel Kroll, the Gestapo's ambassador to Turkey. Yeah, it's out of my hands.
France, you cannot wash your hands clean so easily.
Angelo, what do you expect of me? Now, really, I cannot influence the Gestapo. They despise me as much as I despise them.
Surely there must be others in Berlin who, like yourself, do not want the blood of all these innocent children on their conscience. Enlist their support. You will never have a better cause. Now do it, Franz. Do it for the children. Do it for yourself. Franz.
I will place a call to Zoltz in the Berlin Foreign Office.
Spiritus Sancti. He has the lungs of an Italian tenor. You've sung your aria, my friend. Now, pianissimo. Let Uncle Angelo have his turn, eh? There. Acipe vestem candidam immaculatum ante tribunal domini nostri Jesu Christi, ut abias vitam eternam.
Amen.
Vade in pace, et Dominus sit tecum.
Amen.
Excellency. Excellency, for Lucy, this medal, your blessing.
Better than that. For Lucy, we shall send it to Rome.
Your Excellency, my wife and I will be forever grateful for this honor.
Mr. Minister, it is you who serve Portugal and your church so well, who does honor to my chapel.
I thank you.
Thank you.
Hey, Tommaso, listen to him hit that high C. We may have baptized another Caruso.
To think. In only a few hours, you'll be in Rome.
God willing and nothing interfering.
I'll pray for you, Tommaso.
Eh? Thank you.
I still think flying should be left to birds and angels.
Here is the letter for Cardinal Marioni. Be sure you hand it to him yourself. He is one man who might persuade the Holy Father to intervene personally.
Of course, if Van Papen does manage to change Berlin's mind.
For the sake of the children, we must hammer at every door.
I'm wrapped and my knuckles are raw.
If a door does open, Tommaso, be eloquent. Use all that Irish charm. God go with you.
Sir.
We've been asked by Rabbi Isaac Herzog to meet him here. We have supplies for the children.
You may pass. The rabbi is aboard the ship.
Thank you. See him again this afternoon. Could some of the older boys help unload the truck? We have food, clothing, and blankets. We will bring more later.
Keep the condemned warm and healthy.
Melach, childish petulance is a luxury we cannot afford.
Young man,
God will not abandon these children. I believe he will not. I know he will not. So while we wait for God's will to be done, we keep his children warm and fed.
Please forgive him.
Isaac, I'm anxious to meet your precious cargo.
Dove! Hello! Hello, the truck.
Shalom.
Shalom.
Shalom. Shalom. Thank you. Tell me your name. Your name. I am Angelo. Angelo. Can you say that? Angelo?
Angelo.
Excellent. Just excellent. Now, what is your name? I am Angelo. And you are?
Joseph.
Joseph. That's a marvelous name. Joseph.
Joseph.
Angelo.
What is this? A very remarkable watch.
Papa.
Your papa's watch. Why, that's beautiful, Joseph. Just beautiful. Thank you for sharing it with me. Thank you.
Thank you.
I'm Colonel Günter Kroll, Geheime Staatspolizei. I've been looking forward to meeting the much beloved Archbishop Roncalli for some time now. Please sit down.
I also have been looking forward to this meeting.
The ambassador will be quite touched to hear that his archbishop was the first to pay his respects.
Respects?
Less than an hour ago, an attempt was made on Ambassador von Papen's life.
An assassin?
Yes. Fortunately, he escaped injury.
Have you found who is responsible?
Yes. A Russian, of course.
The good Lord protected the ambassador.
With the assistance of my agents. I shall convey your good wishes and your concern to His Excellency.
I should prefer to see him myself.
My dear Archbishop, that is quite impossible. He was badly shaken by the experience. He's going to leave Turkey, at least temporarily.
Then I must make my plea to you. In the harbor, there is a shipload of children.
I should have known that your humanitarian instincts would lead you to them.
Colonel Crowell, I implore you, let these children stay in Istanbul.
My dear Archbishop, that decision is not mine to make. And you, of all people, should sympathize with my position.
How is that?
You're a servant of the church. You pledged your life to carrying out its orders unquestioningly. Now, you may not always understand why you are asked to do certain things, but you accept the wisdom of your superiors. Like you, I'm merely a servant, and I do what is required of me, unquestioningly.
You send them back. You condemn them to death.
My dear Archbishop, I condemn no one. I merely follow orders, right here and now. Later decisions will be made by high authority. And I'm sure for the good of the Third Reich. Now, if you will kindly excuse me. Auf Wiedersehen, Archbishop, till we meet again.
I will pray for you.
Thank you.
Excellency, the foreign minister called. He urgently asked that you come to the ministry as soon as possible.
Well, thank you, Luigi. Please phone and tell them I'm leaving now.
Angelo! Angelo! Our brother Alfredo. He's dying.
Bergamo. 2 days ago.
They need you at home, Angelo.
I must go to the foreign ministry. They will arrange for us to leave by airplane tonight.
Your Excellency, the President has been contacted by Colonel Crowell with an official protest from Berlin. They state that your activities in this matter may be subversive.
Subversive? Is it subversive to want to save those children?
To future good relations between Germany and Turkey. I am instructed to remind you that you are in our country at the tolerance of the Turkish government. You have no official status here.
Of that, I'm well aware.
Stop meddling or you'll be deported.
Perhaps on the same ship as the children.
Angelo, you've been able to accomplish a great deal in Turkey. Don't throw it all away. Angelo, you are out of your proper sphere, mixing religion and politics.
Perhaps you can tell me in this case how they can be separated.
Oh, I understand that you had to protest.
You understand that I had to protest. I am pledged in my soul to protest, to meddle, to interfere, to subvert, to use any weapon possible to shield those children.
Even to jeopardizing the neutrality of a country whose protection you have enjoyed for 7 years.
Newman, I love your country. The last thing I would want is to harm it or its people. Suppose I could arrange for the ship to go to another neutral port, Barcelona or Lisbon. Would your government cooperate?
No country is going to accept more than 600 fugitives without papers.
But if I could arrange it...
Angelo, deporting you is not an idle threat. The papers are drawn up. I've seen them.
No, my sympathies are with you, Excellency.
With me? Not with me, with the children.
And certainly I would do anything in my power to help, even though they are not ours.
Ours, Mr. Minister?
Oh, I mean of our faith.
Surely that would not be a consideration.
Oh, no, no, but how can Portugal extend her protection to a ship without registry? More than 600 passengers with no legal papers. That is impossible.
Tomorrow morning, those children will be sent back to unspeakable horrors, to their death.
One hears those terrible stories. Almost impossible to believe. One feels so helpless.
Here is an opportunity to do more than to wring our hands and shake our heads.
Your Excellency, if there were the flimsiest legal pretext for my country intervening, believe me, we would.
Do not despair. The good Lord will show us a way.
Colonel Maglione was so sorry that you and he weren't able to sit down together and talk this through face to face. He said it was very difficult to explain the Vatican's position in a short note.
He does it very well. A formal petition will be drafted and presented to the Germans. It will go through channels. In 5 or 6 months, the Vatican will receive a carefully worded reply. And where will those children be then?
The Cardinal insisted on going to the airport with me. Wonderful man. The situation in Rome is very tense.
I'm sure it is. Twice today, Tommaso. Twice today, I've been told to keep in my place. To stay in my chapel. To pretend I do not know what is happening on the outside. And now my dear brother in Christ writes of my dangerous zeal, counsels me to stay clear of excessive political involvement, suggests I pray and put my trust in God. I do pray, Tommaso. I do put my trust in God. I do believe that is not all that God wants me to do.
Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon, Lieutenant.
Just food and clothing?
And some phonograph records.
Ah.
Bring the phonograph records to you?
Yes, they're with the supplies.
Any news?
Nothing. And with you?
The American ambassador can't help us. The Red Cross representative is still trying. I have to meet him in half an hour.
Isaac, we will find a way. Now I must see my friend.
What do you mean you can't go?
I would like you to fly out tonight as we planned. I will follow when I can.
I want you with me.
I must not leave until a way has been found to save those children.
Angelo, our brother is dying.
I know.
If we postpone going home, he could be dead before we get there.
I want you to go, Maria.
But it's your being with him now that could comfort him. Doesn't that mean anything to you?
My heart cries out to be with Alfredo.
Then go to him.
I cannot.
You'd stay away from your brother's deathbed because of some Jews? What kind of a man are you?
Maria.
The Jews are not your concern. Let the Jews look after the Jews.
These two are my brothers.
Oh, all these years when... You should have been making a place for yourself in the church in Rome, looking after your own. Where have you been? In Greece, in Bulgaria, in Turkey. Wasting all those years looking after heathens, outsiders.
No more.
You've wasted yourself on people who hate you, hate the church. And what is your reward? For 40 years of insults and humiliation? Nothing. It's all been for nothing.
Maria. My reward for the past 40 years has been the past 40 years.
Oh, Angelo mio, I'm sorry. I'm so worried for Alfredo, for you. I don't know what I'm saying. Forgive me.
There's nothing to forgive. Nothing to forgive. Sacrament of baptism is holy. Oh, I am tempted. I want to do this thing. I cannot.
Angelo, I do not want you to violate your belief. But you will support us with the Turkish Foreign Ministry and the Portuguese Embassy.
You do not have to ask.
Your Grace, we must hurry.
Yes, Isaac, our time is running out.
Go, go.
Thank you.
Dov Kohansky. Father, Judah Kohansky. Mother, Sarah Foxman Kohansky. Miriam.
Miriam. Last name?
She doesn't know. Doesn't remember her parents.
Excuse me. Why not Miriam Kohansky?
Excellent. We'll give Dov a sister. Parents, Judah Kohansky. Sarah Foxman.
Jewish children with 647 Catholic baptismal certificates. Forgive me, have you examined these documents?
No, I have not.
That's my department, Mr. Minister, and they look as valid as any I've ever issued.
Your Excellency, Turkey is prepared to authorize an immediate transfer of the ship and its passengers to the protection of Portugal.
Of course. You are relieved to shift the responsibility to us.
Portugal is a Catholic country. What better documentation for a child's identity than a certificate of baptism?
Mr. Minister, you told me your country wanted to help.
We do, but this is also unorthodox. I must contact Lisbon.
There is no time.
Then I just don't know.
These children must be saved. This is their last chance. Now we need your help.
Excellency, I'm sorry. Yeah. I just don't feel I have the right to make such a move on my own.
Your Excellency, we are all taking a risk in this, but when you think of what's at stake...
If I could only clear it with my superiors.
Your Excellency.
Our friend must do what he feels is right. Tommaso, you must not forget what you brought from Rome for the minister.
You requested a medal of the Holy Family.
Blessed by the Holy Father for your beautiful little girl.
Lucy.
May she always have the love and shelter every child deserves.
German government, I take possession of this ship and its cargo. Back here, Friedman.
Yes.
Good morning. Are you responsible for the safety and welfare of the children here?
I am.
Early this morning, Your Grace.
Colonel Crowe, would you please ask your men to replace the gangway?
We sail as planned, Your Grace.
Not under that flag.
This ship and its cargo have been surrendered by the Turkish government and are being returned to the homelands.
The repossession order has been rescinded. We have been informed that the passengers on board are Portuguese citizens.
Portuguese?
That is correct, sir. Portugal has extended the protection and privileges of her citizenship to these Catholic children.
Catholic. I see. With what documentation, if I may ask?
Their baptismal certificates.
There are no such documents. These fugitives are Jews, 647 Jews.
Portugal is satisfied that every child on this ship is a baptized Catholic.
Those certificates are false.
See them if you wish.
Now, Archbishop, I think you know they're forgeries.
If you wish to file such a charge, the Chancery will authorize a full investigation. However, with so many churches in Europe destroyed, priests dead or missing, such an investigation could take months, even years.
This ship sails as planned.
The Turkish Army and Navy have orders to stop you. Are you prepared to risk that confrontation?
Put it back. Gentlemen, the Jews are yours. I hope they're worth the price you're going to pay.
Human life is beyond price, Colonel Crowe.
Your Grace, we differ there.
In one of many ways. Isaac. Joseph, you are going away.
Just when we were beginning to be friends.
Friends.
Joseph, I have to leave the ship. You understand? Papa's watch. No. You must keep it always in memory of your papa. Goodbye, Joseph. God bless you.
Shalom, Angelo.
Shalom. Shalom, little friend.
The story is true. He's quite a guy.
The story is true, and he is quite a guy.
Well, we'd better get back to the square. They'll be casting the next ballot soon. And I'm rooting for Roncalli.
Shalom, Angelo.
Angelo Roncalli became Pope John XXIII, the interim pope who in his all too brief reign initiated more changes than any of his predecessors in 1,000 years. Open the windows, he shouted. Let in the fresh air. He will be remembered as the man who summoned the Ecumenical Council, the religious event of the century, the man who wrote the great encyclical Pacem in Terris, Peace on Earth, the first encyclical ever addressed not just to Catholics, but to all men of goodwill. Perhaps Belgium's Cardinal Suenen said it best. He left men closer to God and the world a better place in which to live.